Welcome to the Small Business Voice with Justin Duncan and Liberty Santiago on Power Talk 1360 KFIV, the show that talks to small business owners about the best ways to practice business in our current day from experienced professionals. And we are here every Saturday from 11 a.m. to noon. And this week we have Julio Villanueva from Higher Performance Garage as our guest. I can't wait to talk to him.
Yes.
Yeah, I've been to his shop. He has an amazing shop. Mm-hmm. And he's got quite a story, so we get to learn a little bit about his story.
How did you meet him?
Actually, through a Gold Star member, actually. Not even a current Gold Star member. I kept in touch with him.
Yeah.
And he gave me some contacts, and Julio was one of the ones that actually answered and got excited. And
nice.
Yeah, so.
He's really cool.
He is, yeah.
I have a feeling we're going to learn some pretty amazing things about one of my favorite things, which is luxury cars, European cars. I don't know. Stay tuned, and we'll bring you in some pretty cool info.
Yes. Real quick, we had Chris Diaz on last week.
Mm-hmm.
Chris Diaz is the owner of Woody's Golf Carts.
Yeah.
And I think these two meeting each other sometime soon will probably be a good... You know, maybe a good or bad thing. I don't know, but I think
it should be good. Yeah,
I think it'd be a great thing combining that with higher performance. So, you know, hey,
I love it so much.
Yeah, we bring people together. That's
yes,
what we do.
Absolutely. Yes, absolutely.
So, Liberty, the newly married Liberty, I like to say.
Yes.
Yes. Congratulations on your 2-week anniversary. I'm making. Yes, I am making a big deal about it because I'm happy for both you and Alex.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I'll taper off eventually, but for now.
For now.
Yeah, I'm making a big deal. So,
you know, it feels really weird to be a wife again.
Yeah, that's something. So I've never been a wife, but I've been a husband.
You've been a husband. Yeah. Yeah, you know what I mean.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I've done it once. I got married, you know, fairly young. It wasn't in my teens, but I was in my early 20s when I got married.
Right.
And to take that venture again is... how am I going to put this? It's
through a new lens the second time.
Yeah, it's through a new lens. I'm going to say I have so much business stuff I wanted to accomplish before I even give that even a thought.
Right.
You know, I don't want to get distracted. But, you know, the one thing I did realize is if I do get with somebody, I want them to push me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and you don't want somebody holding you back.
Right.
That comes from loved ones quite a bit.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you're working too hard. You're doing good enough at your job. And you want somebody to really push you forward. Like, hey, that's a great accomplishment, but you got more to do. You know, get out there, get to work.
Yeah.
And you want somebody kind of pushing you out the door, not just because they want you out, but they want to see you accomplish more. So that's something I'd like to see in a mate in the future, in a woman in the future. And vice versa. I mean, you know, if she's got a business, I want to be able to push her and do the same thing. You know, I want somebody that's a team member, not a dictator.
Right. Yeah. So that's definitely what, you know, motivated me and Alex to get married too, is that we are that, you know.
You are a team. Yeah. It's very
cohesive.
Cohesive. Thank you. I'm not so much with the words today for some reason.
That's okay.
But
yeah.
Well, I want to say it's a good example. Mm-hmm. You know, your marriage is a good example of something I want in the future. Maybe not something right away, but something in the future. I want that, you know, where we're pushing each other to do better.
Right.
We're working as a team to make ourselves better. That's what I'm looking for.
Right.
Yeah, in the future.
Right. But you drive a very good point because for the most part, business owners, they're going to have a family. And so, you know, what you can do is be aware that, you know, you're not alone if your family is not encouraging you or supporting you, but you can go out and either, put yourself in a mastermind situation or a networking situation. Like, you know, we're going to talk about at Community Corner, we're going to give you plenty of opportunities to get with the right crowd.
Yeah. People are going to support you and your vision.
That's right. Yeah. But, you know, that was a really good benefit of getting divorced for me was I could then, you know, push myself and then find a mate that, you know, wanted to push me like we have done, me and Alex have done for each other.
Yeah. It's an amazing story. I mean, I got more insight than most people do because you shared it on the mastermind and it's amazing. I never knew how integral he was in pushing you for mm-hmm. more. And he just didn't want that trophy wife that sat in the background and made him look good. He wanted a partner that stood next to him.
Right.
And say, hey, you know, we're a team. We mm-hmm. do this together.
Right. Well, he jokes with me all the time and says that he wants me to retire him. And I'll tell you what, I don't think there's a greater gift that I could give my spouse or a loved one than to be able to do such a thing. You know, because we do have a pretty good age gap. But the thing is I want to retire early. I want him to be able to retire when I'm retiring. And I want us to be able to have a life that is beyond our business, that has to do with the legacy that we've created through our business. And I think a lot of business owners really want that, but they need to learn how to articulate that and be supported in their mindset, in their environment, in strategies, and in their marketing.
Absolutely. So Liberty, now that we've covered everything, let's talk about you for a second. Who are you? You know, what is your business? How can people get a hold of you?
Right. So I'm Liberty Santiago. I'm a personal development coach, and I am also a business consultant. And the best way to get a hold of me is to follow me on Instagram. Just go head on over there and type in LibertyBrand_biz. And there's a link in my bio, which I really enjoy this because it's a way to stay relevant with, you know, different things that are going on. But, you know, you get to really know me and my family and, you know, my mastermind people who I'm helping to support, and you get to see projects like the Small Business Voice. I do a lot of cross promotion on there and get to see the news.
So you're a very integral part in the team of the mm-hmm. Small Business Voice Media, and I want to thank you for that.
Oh, thank you.
So I'm the owner of the Small Business Voice.
Yes.
However, I do not call the shots. It seems like I have other people do that for me. So it works out good.
Yeah.
But my goal is to help out small business owners and entrepreneurs. I just joined Legal Shield recently.
Mm-hmm.
I am your Legal Shield rep. My goal is to help small businesses and employees mm-hmm. Be legally covered at a group level. Mm-hmm. And there's so many different benefits to Legal Shield. I can't even begin to talk about them. But one of them is, you know, getting your will done. You know,
right.
Yeah. Now, if Gianna was sitting here, she'd say, you need to trust too. And I don't think Legal Shield does that. But you mm-hmm. can start by getting your will done. That's part of the membership. Mm-hmm. They have business supplements to where they can help you with a business plan.
Mm-hmm. Contracts.
Contracts.
Got to have those.
You got to have those. I learned that the hard way. Mm-hmm. And there's just so much there to empower not only businesses, but empower people.
Right.
And You always want somebody, you want a legal team behind you.
Right.
And
especially in California.
Especially in California. And usually, like, the very wealthy have a legal team that they'll pay thousands of dollars a month mm-hmm. to have a legal team. You know, this legal coverage is very affordable.
Less than $40, right?
Yeah, I want to say it's around 30 bucks a month.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, like 31.
Well, I have Legal Shield also. I have it for myself, my family, and my business, and I think it's like 37, but that's a lot that we're getting for $37 a month.
Well, yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And my goal when I got into Legal Shield, mm-hmm. and this is a strange story, actually. I wasn't recruited in this time. I wasn't recruited in. I actually sought out the person and said, hey, this is something I want to do. Mm-hmm. I gave her my vision and what I wanted to do. I want to help truck drivers, mm-hmm. and I want to help employees. And I also want to help small businesses. I want to help everybody in the small business area.
Right.
And empower everybody.
Right.
You know, and she goes, hey, you know, I love your vision. She's introduced me to some people. There's a wealth of information on the app. I think it's PPLSIEngage.com. I don't know. I don't know the off the top of my head, but there's a lot of information there. Mm-hmm. And, you know, Liberty and I think we both share this passion and this vision of just empowering small businesses. And I welcome any entrepreneur to come on, but I think I actually really want to focus on our community, on, you know, Stanislaus County, San Joaquin County, you know.
Sacramento County.
Sacramento County. And just focus on small businesses mm-hmm. as a whole, but more locally. I think as I had this vision, it was more broader.
Mm-hmm.
But I think, especially in Stanislaus County, I mean, we've got so many people to help in Stanislaus County.
For sure.
Yeah. And And then you got, you know, Tuolumne County, that's a neighboring county. I mean, there's so, I mean, Modesto's like right in the middle of everything. Liberty and I are here to help, bottom line.
Absolutely. Yeah. If you're outside of that area, you could still come on the show. Which actually, one of our very first guests was Todd Kukon.
Yeah.
And he was in what state?
He was in Wisconsin.
That is so cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And he's a motivational speaker.
I really love the program that he teaches on, which is the DISC profile, which is something that we just did for the mastermind as well.
Yeah.
It's very important that you get to know yourself. So anyways, all things business is here at the Small Business Voice. When we come back, we will have our special guest, Julio Villanueva of Higher Performance Garage, as our guest. And we are going to learn more about what he does in his garage. This is the Small Business Voice with Justin Duncan and Liberty Santiago. Connect with us on the web, smallbusinessvoicemedia.com and mastermind.libertybrand.biz.
So we have our guest, Julio Villanueva, owner of Higher Performance Garage in Modesto. Thank you for being our guest today. I really appreciate that.
Thank you for having me on.
And I know you're busy.
Normally, yeah.
So we were doing the interviews, Liberty. Mm-hmm. He spends the night in his garage. That's how hard they work.
Sometimes,
oh,
yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah, they're dedicated.
Can't wait to hear more about it.
Yeah, because you're a young guy. You look young to me. So how old are you, and how long have you been working on cars?
I'm 31 now. I'll be 32 in December, but I've been working on cars since I was 16, so 15 years nonstop.
15 years nonstop, like 7 days a week?
Yeah, school, yeah. And then working two jobs, which was like work and then, you know, like parts, and then also working at a shop or vice versa different times. And so, like, learning the mechanic stuff while then going to, like, the parts department stuff at a different job.
So, tell me about the certifications I saw on your wall real quick, because I saw that. It stood out to me, and there was probably about 7 different certifications on there, and I never really knew much about auto mechanics, but what kind of certifications do you have to have?
Over the years, you know, the main thing that any manufacturer will look for is, like, an ASC certification. It's very common. It's like your generic certification quality or level of different, you know, duties or different tasks a technician can complete. So it's like your engine mechanical, your brakes, what else? Maybe
transmissions.
Yeah. I don't really follow it because ours is custom. So
yeah. We
kind of step out of the normal boundaries of, how you would say, like, your normal repairs, and so the stuff we do is mainly imagination and, you know,
yeah,
a lot of fun, cool stuff you get to just practice on almost.
Yeah, we get to find out more about that in a little bit. I'm excited. Liberty's got a big smile on her face. You know she just got married?
Oh, congratulations.
Thank
yeah.
you.
That's yeah. awesome.
Thanks. Justin, sticking that in there.
You'll hear it more throughout the day.
Oh, so, all prepared.
So, Julio, you're living your dream. Sometimes the cost of that is yourself and your crew spending the night working at Higher Performance Garage. And it's not always easy chasing a dream. But how has that journey been for you?
It's been very nuts. The best way to describe it is like a, you know, just an uphill battle. You know, it's like you're trying your hardest to, you know, come up in the world as far as being able to, like, make bread and make money to, you know, eventually get buying a house or buying, you know, stuff like that. But it takes a lot of investment, a lot of time, and, you know, 125% of yourself to be able to make your business succeed.
Go ahead.
Well, at the end of the day, you're going to be doing this grind for yourself or someone else, so you might as well be doing it for yourself.
Correct,
right?
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah, well, how many hours do you think you average a week in your shop?
A minimum 12 to 16, minimum. Like, 12 is, like, very low. 16 is average.
It's average, wow.
Every day, Monday through Sunday.
Per day, yeah.
Wow. So we're going to have to talk about sleeping. You know, like, how do you do that and still function?
That's 4 to 5 hours a day sometimes.
Yeah.
Like Alex says, you'll get all the sleep that you need when you're dead.
business owners, how it seems, yes. So you're listening to Justin Duncan and Liberty Santiago on the Small Business Voice on Power Talk 1360 KFIV. Listen each Saturday at 11 a.m. If you want to get in touch with Higher Performance Garage, please contact them on the website, hpgautomotive.com, or call the shop at 209-248-7288.
Thank you.
You know, also my mom used to tell me, she would say, you know, now that you work for yourself, you can work any, you know, 12 hours of the day that you want. And I was like, man, she is right, though, you know, because when you work for someone else, you work this, you know, very routine schedule. So like 8 to 5 or 9 to 5 and you get your breaks and all that. But as an entrepreneur, there's like no breaks. You're lucky if you get to eat like a regular routine meal. And then you just go. You just go because you have that passion to go.
Yeah,
am I right?
Yeah. Fact, yeah. Very, very factual information. Yeah.
That's cool.
So who's your ideal customer right now?
An ideal customer for us is someone that has kind of an idea that they want to bring into, you know, into play. So, like, they have, for example, a GM vehicle that they want to do, you know, modifications on and make more power or make it sound crazy, you know. I know the Central Valley is big on old schools and big V8s, so it's like our ideal clients here are usually people that kind of just want a little more power in general. It could be, you know, we focus more on Toyota and GM and European vehicles, so usually that would be our ideal client or okay. customer.
So custom mods then?
Mostly,
yeah.
Yeah.
Cool.
So if we brought in our 1978 Pinto, you can get that to go 125 miles an hour as long as it was done right?
Correct, LS or Jay-Z swap.
Ooh.
That's the way to go.
That's cool. I had a look at your website, and it's very impressive. And, of course, I saw, you know, some brands I really like Mercedes. And I was like, ooh,
Tell me more.
Yeah. What do you do for a Mercedes?
For most of our clients for Mercedes, nowadays, since the cars are really high-level factory, you know, nearly built cars, they have really good systems. A lot of times you can just either upgrade a turbo or, you know, change the exhaust system, do a flash tune. It's real basic nowadays. You can just upload a flash tune and it's making 60 horsepower off of just a little update or whatever.
Okay.
It's pretty simple.
Okay.
You know, just minor stuff like that. Or, you know, body panels. People like doing carbon fiber parts, forged carbon fiber parts. A lot of aerodynamic stuff, big brakes, nice wheels and tires, you know, suspension settings. It's a lot that mostly exterior guys. I know a lot of the Mercedes people are doing a lot of exterior mods first, and then they're moving on to the performance parts after.
Okay.
That's really cool. You get into all the cool stuff, creative stuff.
Pretty much, yeah. And drilling into brand new cars, it's pretty nuts. They're making holes in these, like, nice, super nice cars. I'm just like, I don't feel bad at all anymore. I'm just like, cool, bring it in, you know.
Yeah, well, people want what they want, so.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, do you ever watch the show Home Improvement?
Yeah, I used to.
Okay, yeah. He reminds me of Tim Taylor. You know, except it's not tools. It's the engines. You know, you want to make engines. Yeah. Go crazy fast, huh?
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, nowadays the power levels are so high for even street cars, and it's pretty crazy. All these, you know, like 400 horsepower is not as fast as it used to be.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Now, do you have to stay within some sort of boundaries or something, you know, to stay, like, legal or things like that?
Well, we have a process to follow with any car. You know, obviously, we have to, like, have them write down this. The car won't be driven on the roads. It won't be driven on the highway. It basically becomes a race car at that point, you know.
Okay.
And as long as they sign for that, I mean, legally, we're usually okay, at least. I mean, in California, it's really hard nowadays to do anything, so... you know, you got to do your best to get all your paperwork situated, make sure the customer's aware, and they sign for that, and kind of leaves us out of the window.
Yeah, I like that. That's cool.
So what kind of automotive work does Higher Performance Garage specialize in?
The best way to describe what we do in that aspect is we do a lot of engine building. We do a lot of turbocharging, supercharging, nitrous. Pretty much all your hardcore stuff that a lot of guys haven't been doing anymore is a lot of people that don't. Do as much as you used to. All the older guys have kind of like stepped away or retired, so then a lot of the younger guys just kind of moved on from away from the field. but mainly, yeah, we do a lot of more kind of horsepower add-ons, you know, try to get more power out of cars or put good handling suspension parts on it, aero parts.
Okay, so as you and I are kind of talking off air or at your shop, it's kind of way you put it, like a dying breed, I guess. Like you're not really seeing that many shops anymore. Can you kind of go into that?
Yeah. So the reason being is I know the EPA has been hard on a lot of shops just because of, you know, there's guys that are racing these high power cars on the streets, and that's not ideal. Ideally, that's not what we would want either.
Yeah.
Just to keep people safe, because we like seeing the results. We like seeing when they get to a track and they're able to do a really good time. It's like, dang, they really you know, beat all these other Porsches, or they really beat all these other like Audis or stuff like that, where it's like you earn your bragging rights at the track versus on the street, you know.
Yeah.
So a lot of shops have been closing because of either, you know, the EPA shutting them down. You know, high cost of operating for custom shops is really nuts, just because it's like your work is not consistent, like oil changes or, you know, you're doing front end or brakes all the time. So it's just like it's kind of a dying breed. Yeah.
Okay. So you're getting these engines to perform higher. So is it, we never talked about this, but is it a dream of yours, like maybe to work on the NASCAR circuit, or, but is that kind of a dream of yours to get on a racing circuit like NASCAR or something like that?
Yeah. I mean, ideally I'd like to start my own corporation, as far as like, you know, having a full team like Hendrix Racing, or, you know, just, you know, different actual companies that are very specialized, where they can have teams, they can have trailers to travel to different tracks all across the U.S. and even international if it's that high level. But yeah, I mean, like a drift team would be ideal for us to have, you know, full-blown pro car and all the fun stuff that goes along with drifting, and even just being able to go to tracks all across the U.S.
Okay, we're going to cover that here in a few minutes. So okay. If you want to get in touch with Higher Performance Garage, please contact them on the website hpgautomotive.com or call the shop at 209-248-7288. Can you share with us a customer success story?
Yeah, I mean, we have a few customers that, you know, they'll go from certain shops or different shops, and they come to us, and, you know, we pretty much get everything situated with all the stuff that was bad before, and, you know, they're happy because they're able to drive their cars everywhere they need to. It's just very important to have, you know, like a good... honestly, happy customer. It is hard sometimes when you're doing custom work, because there's nothing else you can compare it to. But ideally, you know, some of our customers, once they start driving their cars or getting these high, you know, really nice vehicles out on the road, and they're super juiced. And I think every customer has their own, you know, vision or view of, you know, at success as well. But I guess as far as, you know, people that we have dealt with, most of our customers are always just happy to have their engines built or transmissions built or whatever it is to actually get them out on the racetrack or whatever it is, you know.
Well, and that's what I wanted to ask, because we talked about the racetrack a little bit. Yeah. So who does Higher Performance Garage sponsor in racing?
Mainly we try to sponsor people that are really like they really love the sport, they really love what they do. And, you know, it shows with them being able to be very competitive. And if they win, obviously it shows that they're pushing harder than the last guy. You know, they try to get that first, you know, place. They try to get a podium. And those are the people that I like to try to push, because it's like I would want to do the same. You know, it's something that I can relate to and the shop can relate to. So we can try to put that into like, you know, that's the ideal person we'd want to sponsor, someone that has a really big drive to be able to do a little more and try to win.
All right. I like your logo, by the way.
Thank you. Yeah, yes. One of my old friends actually designed it for us.
Yeah, yeah, it looks good. I like the branding you have.
Yeah.
Liberty does. Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah,
it looks really good.
Thank you.
So, curious, what kind of racing do you do? Because I know there's all kinds of racing that is out there. There's, you know, Baja. There's track racing. There's, you know, there's all
video,
kinds.
There's video game racing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Tell me more about the racing.
So, our clients and customers have different, there's so much different aspects that we touch as far as like what the cars can do. So there's cars that we do for drag racing. So those tracks can be anywhere in California, anywhere across the U.S. Circuit racing, which is road racers, guys that are actually on the track, like Buttonwillow, Willow Springs. Mm-hmm. Those are kind of our local ones here, about 3 to 4 hours out each side. And then there's a big track down in SoCal. It's over in, I think, Pomona or San Bernardino. I forget the name. I've only been there like a couple times. But, you know, there's that kind of field. And then there's also drifting, which is really what we're into more.
Cool.
Drifting is, you know, the super sideways,
yes,
you know, reverse entry kind of cool stuff.
Nice.
Where it's like, it's really interesting. It's really fun. It's a lot more sounds. The speeds
right.
are high. It's really cool just because the car is basically
the exhaust and the thunder and all that.
Oh,
goodness.
Yeah.
And the smoke, and it's just, yeah, it's dramatic.
Yeah, rubber flying in your face, you
yeah.
know, just from all the,
like, okay, this is good.
it's a good feeling. But yeah, that's mainly, I guess, we do a lot more of most of our customers are going to be doing circuit racing. Most of them like to go to the tracks. Mm-hmm. You know, and it's kind of fun just to see them out there.
Yeah, and then, like, on the flip side, your average consumer, somebody who wants to come in for an oil change or something like that, is that something that you're doing? Because that's what I see on your website, too. So I see, like, hey, I could come in and get my Mercedes serviced, you know, after my lease is up. Where do I go? I could go to you, right?
Yep.
Awesome.
Yeah, so we do all your basic maintenance as well, brakes. We don't do tires yet, just because we have a shop that's one of our friends that they do tires. And I don't want to compete.
Might as well,
with,
yeah.
You know, so we can share businesses as well. And they're really good at what they do, and we're good at what we do. So it's like, you know, we're all scratching each other's backs in that aspect.
Right. And I know one thing I did want to ask you about is, like, what is the hardest part of setting up your small business?
The hardest part is, I think, having the, I mean, since there's no other really job you can compare it to, it's like you have to have an imagination that has to also work, you know, legally. And that's probably the hardest part of it was, you know, it's like we're building race cars, you know, we're building full blown, you know, just fun cars that are just like people's imaginations put into like, a real life Hot Wheel.
That's cool.
And then, yeah, getting all that with paperwork to be, you know, all together, that's probably the harder part, is to get all that situated, you know, legally, and then being able to kind of, you know, promote that. That's also hard.
A real life Hot Wheel. I like that.
I like that too.
So you're listening to Justin Duncan and Liberty Santiago on the Small Business Voice on Power Talk 1360 KFIV. Listen each Saturday at 11 a.m. And if you'd like to get in touch with Higher Performance Garage, please contact them on their website, hpgautomotive.com, or give the shop a call, 209-248-7288. Thank you. Thank you for coming on. So what does Higher Performance stand out or compare to other automotive repair shops?
So we also do all your basic maintenance. So we're very common as far as like all your, you know, routine maintenance goes. But I guess the way that we stand out is we're also doing major builds, you know, cars that are coming in with, you know, say 200 horsepower and they're leaving with near 2,000, you know, it's really insane.
What? That's intense.
Yeah. I mean, doing sleeve blocks, you know, Darton sleeves, those are like ductile iron, you know, cylinder walls, and then having that, you know, basically built up with forged pistons. And we're a dealer for like CP, Carrillo, Eagle. We're a dealer for these big companies that support that kind of power.
Yeah.
And then, you know, that's where we stand out, is the fact that like we're getting down and dirty with bringing everything down to like bare bones and then building it to be, you know, something that's just abnormally high power, you know, just people are just
that's
like, whoa, dude, this
awesome.
Is insane. You
that's
know?
So
yeah.
Dope.
See, I'd be tempted to drive it on the street, though. I'll be honest with you.
It's hard to tell people no. I mean,
yeah, I would though. Yeah,
yeah. I've met a judge that has a old school. You know, it's like I know for sure his is heavily modified. You know, making it like capable of 800-900 horsepower.
So, Higher Performance Garage is based in Modesto. However, tell us how your service can help people outside the area.
So there's a lot of people that just don't know where to go when it comes to building, like, engines in general. We do a lot of the JZ platform, so Toyota, like the GR platform. We do a lot of the LS platform, so we do a lot of those engines, and those are most of your more common high-power engines that you use that are fairly universal as far as, like, drag racing or circuit racing or track racing, drifting. So we do a lot of those specifically because you can just put that engine into almost any car. And, you know, that's your kind of your go-to engines. And the Honda K24, we do a lot of that stuff too. But less and less, it's been, you know, everyone's just doing an LS swap, and we're pretty consistent at doing that.
Right. Wow. Well, I definitely want to follow, and I want to check out what's new and what's upcoming. So how can I do that?
We have a Facebook, we have an Instagram, we have our nice, like, Google page set up.
Okay.
I don't really have a Snapchat for that, but, you know, mainly we try to just focus on the bigger, you know, media channels like YouTube, which we're still haven't dropped a lot of content yet, but we have so much that we do want to drop. So
cool.
I'm hoping to get a cool video out,
nice.
Like, releasing, and we've had, like, hundreds of vehicles that it's like,
yes.
We want to put out all the content and just as we go. But, you know, editing's hard.
Show the transformation and all that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
A lot of befores and afters, a lot, especially with engine builds, you know, with like the cars come in and some of them get painted too. So it's kind of fun to see the process too, like full paint, engine
Absolutely.
Bay paint.
Absolutely. I'm excited just hearing about
it. Yeah. I'm sure the before and the after are just astounding.
Yeah.
I can't wait to see more. And we're going to like and share and follow Higher Performance Garage also. I mean,
Absolutely. I'm just excited.
Yeah, Higher Performance Garage on Instagram, and then Higher Performance Garage on Facebook. So it's just the full name.
Yeah.
And you see us on there.
All right. Well, we will be sure to like and share.
Yes.
Thank you.
Especially, especially now that you are part of the Small Business Voice family. So
yeah, that's awesome.
I know, I'm glad to be on here. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, thank you. Well, thank you, Julio, for coming on. Mm-hmm. We appreciate you, and we look forward to you. Got a bright future. We're looking forward to that.
Well, yeah, thank you. I appreciate that.
Thank you.
Yes.
So huge thanks again to Julio for taking the time away from his shop to come hang out with the Small Business Voice. Remember to schedule your vehicle's next maintenance or repair with Higher Performance Garage by visiting them on the web, hpgautomotive.com, or by calling the shop, direct 209-248-7288.
Today was all about celebrating business, and we are here to serve our business community and help cultivate success in business. Our guest expert, Julio Villanueva of Higher Performance Garage. What an amazing guy to have on our show. And, you know, you guys didn't get to see this part, but we were able to go over what he would do to my Mercedes C300. And I thought that was so much fun. So,
well, check that on the social media.
Yeah, check it out on social media. Make sure you go see. And, you know, he was like, yeah, this is a great car. This is what I would do to it. And I was like, ooh, yes. Gave me some really, really good ideas. So love having our guests on the show. I learned so much, and I didn't know that he existed. So, yes, like, this is why we're here.
Well, exactly. That's why the Small Business Voice is here. You don't know these small businesses exist. That's why we're bringing them on our show, to bring them to people's attention.
Yes, and, you know, we believe that you cannot afford to go without expert advice on things like your car or your business. So, yeah. Grateful to be here, and go check us out on the web, smallbusinessvoicemedia.com.
And you can follow Liberty on Instagram at libertybrand_biz. Send us a message on our Facebook page and click the like button on Small Business Voice Media, and tell us what you would like Liberty and I to discuss on a future show. So, community announcements, we have Gold Star Referral Clubs. We have 17 different regional meetings are held weekly, and each day during the week. Go to meetup.com for our listing and details. Mine is Downtown Connections. We meet Thursday at noon over at Skewers.
I'm missing their food.
Oh, you're missing their food?
I'm missing their food.
Well, we miss you, Liberty.
Mm, yes. I miss you guys, too.
Yes. There's an emptiness now. So we have the Holistic Chamber of Commerce meeting the third Wednesday of each month at 6 p.m. at the Roundtable Pizza, 3848 McHenry Avenue. Next meeting is September 21st, and that is in the Super Walmart parking lot. So Turlock Young Professionals gather the fourth Thursday of each month at the Grand Cru on Main Street in Turlock. The next meeting is Thursday, August 25th from 4:30 to 6 p.m. Go give them a follow on Facebook and mark going to your next event for reminders and updates. We also have the Turlock Chamber of Commerce. They have their mixers the third Tuesday of each month hosted by different businesses within the Turlock community. Follow them on Instagram at Turlock Chamber of Commerce. And their next mixer is September 20th. From 5 to 7 p.m. in Turlock. Follow Turlock Chamber of Commerce on Instagram at Turlock Chamber for location and details. And that's always to be decided, right, Liberty?
Yeah, it is. And I really like having you guys go check that out so you can see, you know, what is the next location. It's like a pop-up type thing. So you never really know where it's going to be at. It's going to be at, you know, at one of the members' business locations. So that way we can get to know each other's businesses better.
Yeah. You know, before I get to this next one, I just want to give a plug to Amy Blueblock. You know, she was a guest on our show before, but she's the mayor of Turlock, and she did an incredible job.
She's pretty amazing as the mayor.
Or she's doing an incredible job. Yeah, I should say. Yeah. And she was a guest on our show. She talked about Turlock, how she's involved in the community. And I just wanted to say thank you, Mrs. Blueblock. I know you're listening. So
yes.
I'm putting that out there, Liberty. So,
awesome.
Yes. So, and then also we're announcing Turlock's very first co-working space coming soon to the Tower Health and Wellness Center at 1801 Colorado Avenue, brought to you by Liberty Brand Consulting and Leasing. To learn more.
Oh my gosh, I'm so excited.
And get on the wait list for an executive office for a monthly rental. Go to link bio on Instagram at libertybrand_biz or give Liberty a call. 209-535-0708, and she is accepting applications now. And speaking of Liberty, the newly married Liberty.
Justin's got to get that in there a couple more times.
Yes, so I'm Justin Duncan. You're listening to the Small Business Voice on Power Talk 1360, and I love this, the straight-up simple tips. I think a lot of our listeners do. So, Liberty, take it away.
Thank you so much, Justin. Okay, so You know, we're celebrating marriage, celebrating business, celebrating success, all this stuff. So what I like to tell people to do is make sure that you set these milestones in your business and make sure to make a point of it to go out and celebrate those successful milestones. So determine how you are going to celebrate and keep that promise to yourself. Like, Justin, if, you know, we decide if we have a full guest lineup for, you know, all of 2023, we're booked out 6 months in advance, that's something we would want to celebrate, right?
Yeah, I'd do a double backflip and a cartwheel, and I'd look like a gymnast. I'd be
so
happy.
Yes, well, at least we could have Kaylee crop your head on somebody's, you know, body doing that, but yes. Anyways, so like, no, but for real, like if that's your goal, if that's what we're manifesting together, let's say that happens, what are we going to do to celebrate? What would you do?
I'd double backflip and a cartwheel.
And a cartwheel. I would probably take you to dinner, Justin, in a really fancy place, maybe San Francisco somewhere.
Oh, that'd be awesome.
We would go and just celebrate and have a bottle of champagne and
It'd be a month. Yeah. And there's no I in team, so it's taken a whole team of us to get this show off the ground. And just want to say thank you to everybody that's a part of the team.
Yes.
Yeah.
See, we're already celebrating as if it already happened.
Yeah, well, yeah. We're just past a year, you know, and that's a big feat in itself right now. Mm-hmm. And August 3rd is an important day for us because you're married on that day.
It's your birthday.
It's my birthday, and it's the anniversary of our first show.
Yes, it is.
Yes. Radio show, actually. Yes.
So many good things, but, you know, this is really, ties in with the tips that we're talking about. So when you celebrate, and when you create these milestones, you want to, you know, act as if it's already happening when you're planning it out. And then obviously when it is happening, you know, carry that through. And creating weekly, monthly, quarterly, and annual goals for yourself and keep track of your success. And you know this, Justin, because I talk about it all the time in the mastermind, is to have a win journal. So that's where you're documenting your success because, you know, I don't want you to call me one day and be like, nothing's going right. Because then I'll just say, well, whip out your win journal and let's talk about it. Let's talk about the facts. The facts are you are successful. We are successful. You know, those types of things. So, you know, to learn how to apply these strategies in your business, schedule your one-on-one business consultation with me and let me give you some straight-up simple tips for your business. Call or text me 209-535-0708.
So the one thing we forgot to mention is, you know, we have a sponsor now, our community corner sponsor. It's PFC Quality Painting.
Right, PFC Quality Paints. Christian is an amazing painter.
Yes.
And he focuses on commercial painting, but he can also do residential. He has tons of great reviews from people that we also do business with that have been guests on our show. He does painting for them.
Yeah, he does. And I wanted to read out some reviews that he had recently.
All right.
So from Angie, PFC Quality Painters do two big jobs for them, kitchen cabinets and outside patio. They couldn't be more satisfied. Cheryl said they gave us prompt estimate and scheduled our painting. They kept in touch prior to the job. They're prompt arriving and completed the job on time. And that's what you want, especially when it comes to painting. John said they are very responsive and courteous with their communications. And they arrived on time, provided a competitive quote, excellent work ethic and dedication for getting the job done right.
And that's Christian Palomares with PFC Quality Painting. You can reach him at 209-900-3758. And he has an amazing website, pfcqualitypainting.com. Thanks, Christian.
So what questions do you have for us or what wisdom do you have to share? Be sure to leave a comment on our Facebook page, Small Business Voice Media. And check out our website and email us at smallbusinessvoicemedia@gmail.com. Connect with us on the web, smallbusinessmedia.com. And I'm Justin Young with the Small Business Voice, where we give small businesses a big voice. Thank you for listening each week, and we'll be back next week.
Special thanks to our listeners for tuning in this week. We feel your support, and we look forward to bringing you even more value next week.
Now, let's take care of business.
Now, where'd you get that platinum chain with them diamonds in it? Where'd you get that matching Benz with them windows tinted?